If you want to expand your vocabulary or add variety in your speech, then TESOL 3-Minute English is just for you. Hello, this is Amrita, your ESL teacher. Welcome to TESOL 3-Minute English. Today, we're going to learn different ways to say, I don't like it. Instead of just using same expression that I don't like it, we can use different ways to say the same thing and sound like a native English speaker. But be careful about using these expressions. Some expressions can be slightly direct or someone might get offended. Okay, so let's get started with the direct expressions. Number one, I hate. So it's quite direct, but it's just the way to say that I don't like it. For example, I hate my English teacher. I hate Mondays. I hate jazz music. Expression number two, I detest. This is another strong expression to say I totally dislike this. For example, I detest spinach. I detest fish. I detest my chemistry classes. Expression number three, I loathe. Okay, I loathe. The spelling is L-O-A-T-H-E. I loathe. It means I really dislike it. For example, I loathe morning classes. I loathe morning classes. Okay, repeat after me. You should repeat three times after listening to me. It will be really helpful to remember, and make sure you are going to use all these expressions in your real life situations. Expression number four, I can't stand. I can't stand, that means I don't like it. For example, I can't stand this bad smell. I can't stand his never-ending complaints. Okay, repeat after me. I can't stand this anymore. It means I can't put up with this anymore. Another expression is, it's not my cup of tea. It is not so strong like other expressions, but you can use it when you don't really like it. It's not my cup of tea. For example, morning classes are not my cup of tea. Morning classes are not my cup of tea. If you don't really like dog or cat, then you can say, I'm not a dog person. Or you can say, I'm not a cat person. There are some more expressions like, I'm not sure about it. I'm not sure about it. For example, you heard a song and you don't really like that music, but you can say, well, I'm not sure about the song, but yes, it's good. So you are not so direct and you don't want to directly hurt someone that, well, I don't like your favorite music. But in direct way, you can say that I'm not sure about this music, but yeah, it's good. That means you are not really into it. So you just heard me saying you are not really into it. So you can also use this expression like, I'm not really into it. So when you don't really like doing something, so you can say, I'm not really into it. I'm not really into music. I'm not really into yoga classes. There are another expression like, I'm not keen on. I'm not keen on cooking. I'm not keen on advising. I'm not keen on listening to others' advices. So instead of saying, I don't like, you can use a variety of expressions to make your speech colorful and tasty and sound like more native English speakers. I hope you have found this lesson quite good and helpful for you. So next time, see you with more expressions. Thank you. Take care.